Just across the water from where Captain Robert Scott loaded his ship in 1910, a former fishing trawler is being prepared to follow in his wake. Apart from a ton of dried beans, 100 giant salamis, 2 lots of Christmas dinners, enough tea for 35,000 cups, bedtime drink for 7,000 cups, fish paste for 7,000 sandwiches, the most intriguing item is a mini piano that might just have gone along with the great man himself on the original expedition. It was found recently in a cellar, and Peter Malcolm, who's in charge of the ship, has already borrowed it. The mission's been delayed for several weeks by the coal and docks disputes. The climax, an 883-mile trek to the South Pole, called the worst journey in the world, will be attempted by just 2 men.
We will come back because we've taken every measure, including having our wisdom teeth out and appendix shortly, to make sure that we don't suffer the same fate as Scott did. But I'm not stupid enough to say that the Antarctic and its winds and its weather, temperatures down to minus 50, minus 60 degrees centigrade, winds up to 125 miles an hour. I'd be crazy if I said that didn't frighten me, but we feel that we've prepared sufficiently to have a cautious optimism about the expedition.
The round trip across the ice can't be completed in one summer, and like Captain Oates, they may be gone for some time, but they expect to return. Arnold Wilson with the expedition in Scott's footsteps for Thames News.